Well, today, Ben Stroup is an author, consultant, and fundraising specialist who's living the life of his dreams. To get to this place, he had to break a few rules along the way. He also had to awaken what he calls the outlaw within.
Ben Stroup was taught to follow the rules and make logical, sensible decisions. He planned a career in full-time ministry, but his first college job in a church didn't work out. So then he pursued a career in sales, looking for security and stability. That didn't work out either. He was successful, but unsatisfied. That's when Ben made some unconventional decisions. In his new book, Awaken the Outlaw, he reveals what he did and why. Here's a hint. Ben says that finding your true purpose and passion may start with breaking a few rules.
Well, please welcome to the 700 Club our dear friend Ben. It's good to have you here.
It's great to be here.
Reading your book, I learned a whole lot about you that I didn't know. You had a crisis. You went through three major things. Arthur Anderson, Enron, and 9/11. All of that's happening in a very formative time in your life, and you had this crisis where you said, well, you can follow all the rules, you can do everything right, and you can still get wiped out. So what did that do to you, and how did that change you?
It was something that I didn't expect and would never have anticipated, but when it happened, it wrecked me. And it left me very disillusioned, left me wondering the path that I was on was even something that I should do. And for the first time, I felt lost.
Well, what happened? I talked about the broad things that were going on in American culture, but something very specifically happened to you.
Right. So I was a youth minister while I was finishing up college, and was doing everything that I knew to do, reach out to at-risk teens and grow the youth ministry and reach out to those who weren't there, and they were coming, and their parents were coming, and it was an exciting time to be a part of ministry. And what was happening behind the scenes was something that I wasn't even aware was happening. But all of a sudden, it exploded in this moment, in this experience, and I realized that I'm sitting around the table with people who call themselves Christians, who are supposed to be supporting me and advocating me, and they've been working to unseat me. And get me out of the way, and I didn't know how to process that.
Did you ever find out why?
You know what? I didn't. I'm not saying that I probably didn't make a mistake or two along the way, but I did what I thought I was supposed to do: reach out, grow, you know, change, help introduce the gospel to people who hadn't had it before. And I thought I was doing everything that I was supposed to do and do all the right things, and all of a sudden these people were upset with me for some reason that I had no idea. And so that time or that experience and several experiences following that just felt to me to be very toxic.
Well, what did you do with that?
I decided not to pursue the path that I was on, which was completely engineered to go into full-time ministry. I was going to finish school. I had gotten a presidential scholarship, and part of that was because I declared an interest in full-time ministry. My minor was in Greek and Hebrew, so by my senior year, I was teaching, helping as a teaching assistant for first-year Greek students, and I was reading Hebrew at some local events and that, and so everything was engineered for me to go to divinity school and then on to full-time ministry, and it left me so broken that my spirit just wouldn't let me go down that path. And so for the first time, I was uncertain about what was next.
So you were on a track to be a pastor.
Yes.
And that was the dream. And then you found, well, it's not a dream.
It wasn't a dream at all. It was a nightmare.
And in your book, you say, awaken the outlaw. So your outlaw got awakened.
Absolutely.
What does that mean? Because that can be, you know, I'm thinking desperados waiting for a train kind of thing. is that the outlaw you're talking about? What are you talking about?
When I refer to the outlaw, it's really kind of this mythic figure, and it's this experience that we have as individuals, and I believe we have it multiple times in our lives, where there's something within us that becomes in contrast with our current reality. And it begins to cause us to see things in new ways and think about things in new ways. And it causes us to open our eyes and our hearts and our minds to new paths that we hadn't seen before. Or ever even considered. And so we need, God uses that part of us, those experiences, to position us for something else and something that we would never have planned for or anticipated.
What you just described is essentially every Old Testament prophet. They always were breaking the mold. They weren't following down the traditional path. They always broke out and followed the inspiration rather than the ritual or the form. They wanted to break out and do something new.
Yeah.
Is that you?
I've never quite thought of myself as an Old Testament prophet, but I think we all go through this period of transformation, mm-hmm. and probably not just once. It's a continual, and it's really because God's not interested in our destination. God's interested in shaping us to become in more alignment with His intention and His purpose and His design for our lives.
Okay. Well, in your book, you go from outlaw to magician. What does that mean?
Yeah, absolutely. So magician is again, kind of another mythic archetype, if you will, and it really represents the power of transformation. So if you think about, you know, the when we begin to separate ourselves and begin to see things differently and think in new ways, and that it begins to usher in a period of change in our lives. And through various trials and tribulations, success and failure, you know, and loss, those things shape us into new people. And the magician, that phase of that change, that really represents how we're formed in a brand new way.
For me, I had a moment where I really realized I can invent myself, that there's more to it. There's certainly background, history, family, all of that. But you get to invent your future. You don't have to walk down a particular path. And you know, I just found that life-changing.
That is, absolutely. I mean, I think about the pressure I felt growing up about finding God's will for your life, right? And the way it was always positioned to me, maybe this is the way I heard it. I don't think anybody meant it in an ill-intentioned way, but it was that there was this one idea, this one path. And I felt like I had found this one path. And so when it didn't work out, it left me devastated because I felt like I had let God down.
Let's talk about the final one, the final transformation, the hero part of the book. How do you get to the hero stage?
Absolutely. You know, we sometimes think about heroes as the one who swoops in and saves the day. We think about the superhero type image of Superman. But really, truly, what a hero is, and the way I talk about it, is when we take what we've learned and we bring it back to the people we initially separated from, and we see our lives as a personal offering. Mm-hmm. I think God is really pleased when we take what's been good and what's been bad, and we've allowed it to change us, and then we, in turn, allow that story and allow those experiences to influence the change of others.
What's next for you?
Well, for me, a big part of what I do and continuing to write is to work with leaders and help them craft their messages and ideas. So there's even though I've had an experience of writing a lot of books, not all of them have my name on it. And so I love working with people who want to change the world in a very particular way. And all right. I'm just delighted that I get to keep doing that.
Change the world and awaken the outlaw. Well, Ben's book is called Awaken the Outlaw, and it's available wherever books are sold. And I encourage you, if you're wondering, if you feel stuck, you can get unstuck. All it needs is a few ideas, and Ben's book will give that to you. So it's available, Awaken the Outlaw. Ben, thanks for being with us.
Thank you very much. All right.